Hello everyone, welcome to another video. So today we're going to do map scales in this video. So let's start. Okay, so in a map scale, there are always going to be a scale. So in this case, the scale is 1 is to 100,000. So what it means is, if it is 1 cm on the map, in the actual place, it is actually 10,000 cm. Okay, so there are some things that you have to take note over here. In any scale, the units are the same. So this number 1 and this number 100,000 are both the same units. And usually for a map, it is in cm. Okay, you can't have like a map with like 1 meter. It's a bit too big for a map, right? Okay, so the next thing is, because this is a cm and cm, these two are cms, in order to get cm to cm square, sometimes you will need to get cm square. What you do is you square both sides. So in this case, you square this number, you square this number. So from cm to cm, they're going to be cm to a cm square to cm square. So by the same theory, if you need to get from cm to cm cube, which is length to volume, you just cube both numbers. Okay, so some of the things you've got to take note when you are solving questions, usually you want to change to the unit you need. After that, then you change the length to what you need. So let's have an example over here. So if you look at the question over here, they say that actual length of a river, if it is 5 cm on the map. So let's fill up what we have. So it's 5 cm on the map, and this one is a question mark. So usually all the questions, we start with the scale first. So I've written the scale here, so it's 1 cm to 100,000. And eventually, we know that you want to get 5 cm is to, this is a river, right? So it makes sense to make it kilometers. So if you look at here, when solving questions, you want to change the unit you need first. So I need km. So my first job is to get this cm to change to kilometers. So 1 cm. Is equal to you got a minus 50, so 1 kilometers, and since I want 5 cm, so from here to here I'm going to times 5, so I'm going to do the same thing here, so times 5, so this will be 5 kilometers, and this will be the answer. Okay, so the next question is ask you, what is the length of the river on the map if the actual length is 20 kilometers? So eventually you know that I want to know this is 20 kilometers because the actual length is 20, and then this is how many cm. So same thing, we need to do the unit first. So from cm, I need to change to kilometers. So straight away it's going to be 1 kilometer, and then this is 1 cm. So from here to here, I'm going to times 20. That's why this is going to be 20. So times 20. So here I will do the same. So 20 cm is the answer. So it's quite easy. So let's do the last one. You notice that this is actually 4 cm square. So this is the area. So same thing, I'm going to start with the map scale. So okay, so I'm going to change the cm to kilometers first because I want the actual area. So eventually at some point I need kilometer square, so I'm going to change to km first. So again, minus 50, so it's 1 km. Okay, so from cm I'm going to change to cm square, and then from this kilometer I'm going to change to kilometer square. So I'm going to square both sides. So I'm doing this part here. I'm going to square both sides so that I get the area. So this is cm square. Now this is kilometer square, and it happens to be 1, so actually 1 square is still 1, and then eventually I want 4 cm square on the map. So this becomes 4 cm square. So same thing, I'm going to times 4, so by common sense it's going times 4, so it's 4 kilometers square. So that's the basic idea of this map scale kind of question. So now let's go through another question, because this question is slightly different. You notice that they give you the actual size of a pond, Then they give you the size of the pond on the map. But what they never give you is they never give you the scale. So it's one is to n. So we are supposed to find this n here. So as you must remember, so when we talk about a scale of a map, it's always cm is to cm. So for A, you see that we're looking at map and actual. Eventually we want 1 cm is to something something cm. So where do we start? We start from these two numbers that they give us. So they give us the actual one is 125 meters. So this is 125 meters squared. And on the map is 5 cm squared. So based on our rule, we always want to work towards the units first. So from cm squared, I want to change it to cm and meter first. So what I do is I'm going to square root both sides. It's going to be square root 5, and this is going to be square root 125. And now I got cm and meter. So this cm is fine, and I want the meter to be changed to cm. So meter changed to cm, I'm just going to times 100. So it's 125, this one, square root, times 100, and this will become cm. And this one is still square root 5 cm. So after that, I'm going to change from square root 5 to 1, so that's divided by square root 5, and so on. The same thing here, divided by square root 5. So eventually, I'm going to get, let's press my calculator, and the answer is 500. So that's the answer. So once you got the scale, actually, part B is very, very simple. So with that scale, the length of a line on the map, which represents a path 13 meter long. So in essence, I need to start from the scale 1 cm to 500 cm, and eventually I want 13 meters because the path is actually 13 meters long. So this is the actual length. So same thing, we want to get the units first. So I want to change the cm to meter, so that'll be 5 meters, 1 cm. After that, I'm going to get from 5 to 13. So what I do is I get 1 meter first, and so this will be 1 over 5 cm, both sides here by 5, and then finally I'm going to times 13. So this will be 13 over 5 cm. So if you change this to decimal, there will be 2.6 cm. So that's the answer. So this is the kind of a question that are very common and very basic. So hope you've learned something. Thank you and bye bye.